Because we know without you, we place where there'll be no crying, no dying. Be blessed out of Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Amen. Praise the Lord. Walk with me, Lord. Walk with me. With me. Walk with me. Be the
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How many got him on the inside? How many got him on the inside? And know he's working on the outside. And that's got to be a great change in your life. Amen. We're going to do this one and then we're going to take our seats. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Woo. Hallelujah. When it's Jesus on the inside.
Evangelist guest, then selection, then arrival come. Talk about my God. Uh-huh. My God, why have thou forsaken me? Amen. And then Rob coming back up. Amen. Lord, we share our thirst.
Yeah.
Amen. And Reverend Brown coming back. Lord, we talking about it's finished.
Oh, yeah. It's
finished. And at the end, we got the best of last. We got our pastor coming up on closing out after the selection. I follow unto thy head. I commit my spirit.
Wow.
Amen. So we thank God for that. And so we're going to get ready to move on. I believe one of our ministers is here. Amen. God bless you, Lord. Come on in. Amen.
Amen.
Come on in.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. You're a guest.
Bless the Lord.
Yeah, bless the Lord. Okay.
All right. Well, we see. Thank God for you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Your faith. So what we're going to do, we're going to move on to our second.
Yes.
Our second word.
Right.
Okay. This medicine. All this takes place. When Jesus is on the cross.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Right.
Everything is going to be shared tonight. Right. Happened when Jesus was on the cross.
On the cross.
Right.
Amen. Nice. So we're going to come up now, ask Minister Brown to come with our second saying.
Amen. Amen.
Come on, give him one of them.
Amen.
I want to say this to all my speakers. You got 12 minutes on each word.
All right.
About to say 10.
Amen.
Amen. When somebody give you two, maybe I'll take 10. 12. But we want to leave. We have seven words. We want to give 10 minutes to each subject. This time, Minister Brown is coming.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Such a wonderful privilege to be in the house of the Lord again.
Amen.
To my pastor and First Lady, I just greet you in the name of Jesus. And to all the ministers and deacons that's here, we praise the Lord for another opportunity to be in the house of the Lord. To our guests that are here, and those that are on their way, we praise God for you. Amen. We are in a season that is absolutely wonderful. Amen. There are a lot of people that's out there doing many things and really forgetting about the purpose behind this day. Amen. This time that we have off from our work, our jobs, and different things. Kids are out of school, and this is a time where we really put in remembrance, amen? Because Jesus is not no longer on the earth, amen? But of course, we do have it in the Word of God, and so He calls us to remember, amen, the things that He has done. So I'm going to speak to you from Luke 23:43. And the second word, amen. Amen, amen, amen. 23:43. In verse 43, amen, amen. And Jesus said unto him, verily I say unto thee, today shalt thou be with me in paradise.
Yeah.
Or if you want to say it another way, I assure you, today, you will be with me in paradise. An assurance is something that settles the matter. You don't have to question it any longer. It's something that puts you in a place of relaxation. You can be comforted in that assurance. Amen? You can almost say, I promise you, amen, that you will get this thing. And so as Jesus hung on the cross, he was mocked by leaders and soldiers.
Amen.
One of the criminals being crucified with him added his own measure of scorn.
Uh-huh.
But the other crucified criminal sensed that Jesus was being treated unjustly. Amen. How many know that Jesus was being treated unjustly? He did not die a death that he robbed a bank or beat someone up or acted unseemly, but for some reason, Jesus was being treated unjustly. But the other criminal, say the other criminal, sensed that Jesus was being treated unjustly, and after speaking up for Jesus, he cried out. Now, it's not that Jesus couldn't speak up for himself, but I think the criminal saw himself in a position where he might have an opportunity to speak to Jesus and request something. Because as Jesus was on the earth doing the miracles and traveling from town to town, don't you know his name was noised abroad? And people had heard about this man called Jesus. And this criminal probably didn't have the opportunity to ask Jesus for something or to ask for salvation. And so as he hung on the cross, he saw a window of opportunity. And after speaking up for Jesus, he cried out. And he said, Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. God has a kingdom, amen, world without end, amen. It's not the kingdom like our kingdom down here that's about ready to be wiped out because of sinful natures and man's bad behavior, but it's a kingdom that there is peace and there is safety. There is joy unspeakable and full of glory. In his kingdom, hallelujah, world without end, there is love, amen. And there is joy, and there is peace. And I think for just a moment, this criminal got a glimpse of what the Lord was talking about when he was on the earth. So he cried out after standing up for Jesus one last time. He got an opportunity to do something good on the cross. Hallelujah. As he laid there before he gave up the ghost, he got an opportunity to ask Jesus to forgive him, Jesus, to give him an entry, hallelujah, into that place where he was going. And you have that opportunity today. You and I have that opportunity today that if you're at your last moment in time, you can cry out to this man, hallelujah, and ask him to forgive you, hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. So Jesus then responded to this criminal. He said, I assure you.
Yes.
Ain't that wonderful? When you can ask somebody something and they can give you the confidence. Oh, and tell you it's going to be all right. Jesus said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Oh, yes, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. He said, I assure you today, not tomorrow. Hallelujah. Not next year. Not 10 years from now. Not 15 years from now. But I assure you right now, today.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For tomorrow. Anybody, but today is right now. Today is the day of salvation. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So he said, you will be with me in paradise. What is paradise? The word paradise from the Greek word is paradisios, which means or meant garden, was used in the Greek or Old Testament as a word for the Garden of Eden. In Judaism, of the time of Jesus, it was associated with heaven.
Yes.
Amen. And I think it's still associated with heaven.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. I want to go to heaven. I heard that I can walk on streets of gold. Hallelujah. I heard that the music, the water, and the trees, when you brush against them, it sounds like music. Oh, when you walk around heaven, glory, the gates are of pearls. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, Jesus. They got rubies and diamonds all laid up on the gates. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Jesus will be there. The angels of the Lord will be there. God will be there. Hallelujah. Oh, there will be peace. Hallelujah. description of the garden. There was a garden called Eden back in the book of Genesis that before man entered into sin or error or disobedience with God, that garden was perfect. There was nothing in there that was not perfect. Even the man that God created was perfect. Hallelujah. Until sin came in. So there's coming a day when the Lord is going to restore back Eden to its former state. And we will live in peace. The lion shall lay down with the lamb. Glory to God. And then there shall be no war. There shall be no murmuring or complaining. There will be peace and all will be at rest. Paradise was sometimes thought to be the place where righteous people went after death. This seems to be the way Jesus uses paradise in this passage. You know, after you have labored and after you have suffered and after you've gone through your turmoil here on this earth, ain't nobody want to go to no fire and brimstone, hell burning, fire quenching, glory to God. No water to drink place where you are tormented day and night, in and out, glory to God. No peace on the right side, no peace on the left side. You don't want to go to that place. You just want to get out of this body and go somewhere where you can just dance around heaven all day. Somebody say amen. Thus we have encountered one of the most astounding and encouraging verses in all of the scripture. Jesus promised that the criminal would be with him in paradise. Jesus is no respecter of person. Hallelujah. He is not looking whether you're rich or poor. All he's looking for is a soul that would cry out, I love you, Lord. I heard your voice. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And he told me all I was. Glory to God. Get the text of this. And Luke gives us no reason to believe this man had been a follower of Jesus or even a believer in him in any well-developed sense. He might have felt sorry for his sins, but he did not obviously repent. Rather, the criminal's cry to be remembered seems more like a desperate last gasp of effort. I'm going to give it one more try. I'm going to see if this is what they said about this man, Jesus. This man from Nazareth, Mary's baby. I'm going to give him one more try. And I'm going to cry out to him and pre-adventure everything they were telling me before I got this whole road across. It's true. Though we should make every effort to have the right theology, I'm closing. And though we should live our lives each day as disciples of Jesus, in the end, our relationship with him comes down to sin.
thank you, Minister.
Yeah.
That was a word from on heaven.
Amen.
On high. And then you demonstrate how what Jesus really
is.
We not gonna be humble on that cross. Was to give us all forgiveness.
Right.
Give us all sin.
Yeah.
Amen. Right. All of us. Whosoever
will,
let him come.
Come.
Amen. So I'm going to come right behind this crowd, and I'm going to speak on the fourth word. Amen. Other speaker will rest here for a moment. And she come back.
God bless you, Lord.
Amen. Not together. There's no one selection.
Amen.
We just tear this book. We look at selection now. Amen. I'm going to ask our own brother Ed.
Hallelujah.
You know what I'm saying? So,
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Come on, give God some praise in the house. Woo. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Woo. Glory to God. Amen. On your handout that we gave you, 188, it says glory to his name. Amen. We go back to the way back. Amen. 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 Woo, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Down at the cross, hear my Savior cry.
Come on and praise God. Come on, church, let's praise the Lord tonight. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah. We worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You worthy, O God. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
He knew fourth
He knew that most passionately that there would be some things that he must complete.
Yeah.
And one of them was he needed to die upon the cross.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. But why he was dying upon the cross, yeah, he had to let his father know.
Yeah.
Say, Father, if it can happen,
yeah,
if it's your will,
yeah,
then I just come reform me. Let it happen.
Yeah.
But as Jesus, as he began to express the anguish and the angriness of being,
yeah,
being tortured and,
yeah,
and being humiliated and,
yeah,
being spat on,
he
still showed compassion. And he showed compassion until he showed it for you and I.
Yes.
Uh-huh. He did this. He said, Father, please, he said, if you can, will you help me, Father?
Yeah.
But Jesus realized, being in the Spirit too,
yeah,
he realized that he must complete this act of on the cross. For me and you to have salvation,
be
forgiven of our sins. So I thank God.
But
he knew exactly what he had to do. But yet still, being in the natural, he still showed how a natural man would cry out for his father. Yeah, I said the natural. But then, we want to show you that Jesus,
yeah,
was a man who was after God's own heart.
Amen.
And then being in this side of heaven, we would never fully know what Jesus was experiencing. We don't really know. We can come up with the explanation.
Amen.
But in this moment, was he asking the question because he was in misery?
Well,
because he was suffering?
Well, no.
He did not know why God had abandoned him.
Yeah.
Question.
Amen.
Uh-huh. This is the Son of God.
Yeah.
Was his crying not so much a question as an expression of anger, being angry?
Amen.
Or was it both? What we do know that Jesus entered into the hell of separation from God.
Yeah.
He had to come from God.
Amen.
Then God allowed him to be in flesh, and you're going to see, he eventually going to defeat hell. The Father abandoned him because Jesus took upon himself the penalty, for his sins.
Yeah.
In that moment, he experienced something far more horrible than the physical pain.
Yeah.
The beloved Son of God knew what it was like to be rejected by the Father.
Uh-huh.
As we read 2 Chronicles 5:21, God made him who had no sin.
Yeah.
Somebody say, no sin.
No sin.
For us, so that in him we might begin become righteous men.
Yeah.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And then so with this, we ought to say, Jesus, thank you. Because of you, we've been forgiven. And I'm here to tell you, thanks to God, we in this world, natural world right now, we need to call upon our Heavenly Father to help us to receive the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
I'm so glad that Jesus said he must must expediently go away when he's preparing his disciples for what was about to happen.
Yeah.
But he had to go away to give us something called the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
And then when we receive this presence of God, we were to guide ourselves correctly. We would have a discerning spirit.
Yeah.
And we'd be able to know all truth.
Yeah.
And so we thank God.
Yeah. Amen.
Would somebody say thank God?
Thank God.
That Jesus said to his Father.
Yeah.
Just like we say, as for children do this, even adults.
Amen.
Ask for questions. Why? And Jesus in the Father. Why have God forsaken? But in the end, Jesus knew why. Being God in the flesh, he knew. But because he was in the natural, he wanted to show everybody that witness, that form of crucifixion.
Right.
He wanted to show them that I am a man.
Amen.
That's why they call him the Son of Man.
Right.
So we thank God for Jesus.
Amen.
The man who taught us all how to say,
my God,
my God, my God, why have thou forsaken me?
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah. Bible says here, I'm going to move back just a little bit in verse 33. It says, and when they had come to the place called Calvary, there they crucified him. And the criminals, one on the right and one on the other on the left. Then Jesus said, now this is after they had nailed him, they had beaten him, they had spat in his face, false accused. How many have been false accused? Talked about, lied on, mistreated, beaten, whipped, banged up on. Made fun of, called names. Glory to God. All these things in disgrace. Finally, he's on the cross. And he's on the cross. And he's interceding. Because, you know, he could have called him, leave the angels. And said, you know what? Get this. I'm not going to be up here. You know, a lot of times we as believers, we know the Bible says we're going to go through things too. Amen. Not only just the world, but there's some folks right here in the church. They're going to mistreat you. And you might say, you know what? I'm not going to take it. I'm going to hang up my religion. I'm going to let that out. I'm going to keep my peace out of my mind. I'm going to tell them something. I'm going to get out and I'm going to show them what's happening. Many people, they don't take nothing. They'll say they're a Christian, they're in church, they're rejoicing, praising God, but they're out there working the wrong way.
Oh, yeah.
He's just false. verse 20 of that same chapter.
Yeah.
He said, glory God. Let's go to 22.
Yeah.
Let's go to 22. Then he said to him the third time, why? What evil has he done? What evil? If you find it hard, difficult to forgive, go to God.
Amen.
He'll help you.
something right now. Say they love God.
Right.
Don't know how to. That's it.
Right.
All right, so what we're going to do, I'm going to ask Mr. Brown, get us some song, and then to get us back. If you want to go to the next word.
Go to the next word.
Yeah,
amen.
Well, we need Mr. Brown to come up and talk to us about our
thirst. Our thirst, amen.
My Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. How many love the Lord?
Amen.
Oh God.
Amen. Hey, I'm just revved up. Amen. I had to cut it off a little bit there. Go sit down. Amen. I'm revved up. Amen. Amen. I love the Lord tonight. Amen. And reading this one more time to those who came in after a little bit later on to Prophetess Friesen. And her wonderful husband and sister, and I believe that's a grandbaby over there. All right, so wonderful to have you all here with us tonight. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Yes, let's get into this book here, John chapter 19 and verse 28. Amen.
Amen.
John chapter 19 and verse 28. Amen. Just to set the scene a little bit, I'm gonna read. From the very first, just passing through a few of those scriptures just to kind of set the scene where we're going and why Jesus had to cry out and say what he said. Amen. It says, then Pilate therefore took Jesus and scourged him, and the soldiers plaited a crown of thorns and put it on his head, and they put it on him a purple robe and said, King of the Jews. Yes, Lord. And so then they said, and they showed him with their hands. In other words, not only did they put that on his head, but they were slapping him. Slapping at his back, in his face. Yeah. Wherever they could hit him, they were slapping him. Amen?
Amen.
Praise God. And it says here that Pilate therefore went forth again and said unto them, behold, I bring him forth to you.
Amen.
Oh, I'll bring it. I don't want to have nothing to do with this man. I've got a lot of power, but I have a feeling. Because see, Pilate was going through some things in the midnight hour that nobody else knew about. Amen. And so he said, I'll bring it to him, to you. Amen. And then the word of God says, he says here, I'm bringing him to you. And he said, that you may know that I find no fault in him. Isn't that amazing? That he found no fault in the Lord, but yet he was bringing him to the people. According to the custom at that time, they had to do something with the man that was accused. Amen? They either had to let one go or crucify one. Amen? And then when the governor or the emperor or the pharaoh could not decide on what was to be done, the people had the say in the matter. Amen? Then came Jesus forth wearing the crown of thorns and the purple robe. And Pilate said unto them, behold the man. When the chief priests therefore and officers saw him, they cried out saying, what did he say? Crucify him, crucify him. Pilate said unto them, take ye him and crucify him, for I find no fault in him. Amen. And so here we are coming up to the 28th verse. Amen. I can't read it all, but all of it goes on to talk about what they did to Jesus and how he was suffering at the hand of the people. Not only were they scourging him and slapping him, but they were screaming out, crucify him, crucify him.
Yeah.
The same Jesus. Jesus that just healed their child, the same Jesus that just took them out of their troubles and tempestuous seas and storms. The people was yelling, crucify him. So no doubt, amen.
Yeah.
No doubt Jesus experienced extreme thirst as he went up on the cross while being crucified. He would have lost a substantial quantity of bodily fluid.
Yeah.
Both blood and sweat. Through what he had endured even prior to the crucifixion. Thus this statement, I am thirsty. Because you know, when you lose water from your body, when you lose all of the substance in your body, and the sun is beaming down on you, the crows are perching around because they can smell the dead angel. Oh, just hovering around, waiting for that flesh to drop. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God, that carcass to come down and for them to discard it. Hallelujah. The crows were hovering over. Oh, but Jesus was not yet ready to give up the ghost. So he cried out one more time. He said, I'm thirsty. It was the most obvious level, a request for something to drink. In response, the soldiers gave Jesus sour wine. And if you ever had vinegar without any sugar, even when you put sugar in it, it's still not tasting good. It's still sour, glory to God. It still don't have to make your teeth go on edge. Make you feel like your hair is coming out of your head. They didn't have no sugar in this sour wine. It wasn't water, glory to God. Mixed with the heat and the sun and the burning and the scorching of the sun coming out on Jesus. Oh, glory to God. His sweat was coming out, but he was thirsty. Hallelujah. So he cried out. And do you think that somebody would come and give the man of God a good drink of water? Oh, no. They said, I'm going to fix you a little bit more. We hate you this much. The demons are waiting to take your soul away. And you better give it up now. You're not going to go back. You can't fulfill your mission. You can't fulfill your goal. You can't fulfill your purpose. I'm going to try one last time. I'm going to give you something that's going to make your mind go crazy. I'm going to do something to you that's going to turn you upside down. And when I do it to you, you won't be able to call out to God. You won't call out to me. Because I am Satan. That's what the devil was saying, you see. Because there was a battle for the soul, even on the cross. Woo, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We got 10 minutes. Oh, glory to God. So this statement, I am thirsty, was on the most obvious level a request for something to drink. In response, the soldiers gave Jesus sour wine in verse 29, a cheap beverage common among lower class people in the time of Jesus. You know, some people don't even regard you. When you are God has exalted you, they still keep you down there. Make you look like you ain't nobody. You look like they don't want to give you your recognition. They don't want to talk to you like you've been elevated. They want to still keep you down there. But Jesus knew when he was on the cross who he was. When he walked the streets of Galilee, he knew who he was. He knew who he was. He knew where he came from. So he didn't worry about it. He just said, I must be a
Hallelujah. Brother, he said, I am thirsty for him. My soul yearns for the living water that Jesus supplies. According to John 14, 7, 38 through 39, he said, I rejoice in the fact that he suffered physical thirst on the cross.
Amen.
And so much more, so that my thirst for the water of life might be quenched. Hallelujah. Somebody lift your hand and say, quench me, Lord. Come on, lift your hand and say, quench me, Lord. Quench me, Lord. Till I thirst no more. God bless
Bye.
Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Oh, blessed be God's name. More than enough. Glory to God. Amen. Right here in this passage, John 19 and 26. Amen. But I want to read with the end of God. It says, therefore, the soldiers did these things.
Yeah.
Now they are stood by the cross of Jesus, his mother.
That's right.
And his mother's sister.
Yeah. Yeah.
Many Mary, the wife of Cleopas, and Mary Magdalene.
All right.
When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing by, he said to his mother, woman, behold my son.
Yeah.
Amen. Then he said to the disciple, behold your mother.
Yeah.
Amen. And from that hour, that disciple took her to his own home.
Yeah.
I love the part where he says, he saw them standing by.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Glory to God.
Yeah.
That's a strong thing.
Amen.
It's so important.
Yeah.
When you're going through something,
before my car. make it to the end of your list. By the time when you get down to my name, I might be vulnerable. Thank you, teacher. You gotta have somebody in your life.
Or you keep on living, you will be there. Glory to God. I've been in the desert.
Glory to God. Yes. Jesus. Yes. And I feel all alone. And God, He put people in my pathway. Yes. The Word of God says that. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Yea, though I walk through the valley.
Yes.
I might be going through it, but I ain't going to pick up the house and live there. Glory
yes.
to God. Hallelujah, God. I'm going through it. Yes. That means that at some point, I'm going to come out.
Yes.
Glory to God. And then the whole scenery is not just a valley. The valley begins to go incline. So eventually, I'm going to end up on the mountaintop.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
He
got praise at that point. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
He said, woman, behold thy son. Glory to God. At some point, you might need, amen, your kitchen paint.
Yes.
You might need someone to do some work around the house. Right? Some yard work.
Yes.
And then you got a son. Or you might want to have tea. Or you might want somebody to invite over at the church on Sunday.
Yeah.
I'll give you a son. Glory to God. The Bible says then he said, from that day on, he took her as his own family member.
Uh-huh.
Glory to God. The same way we are adopted into the family of Christ.
Yeah.
The same mannerism. He gave us power to become sons.
Yeah.
And daughters.
Yeah.
Glory to God. Well, you may not have been born in a Jewish line, but because of Jesus, you are also a Jew. You're just as if you were born in the family of the genius.
Yeah.
That you are just as important.
Yeah,
Lord, we all are.
Yeah.
Amen.
We are adopted into the royal family.
Yeah.
Glory to God. Glory to God. You are outside.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
We are all in the family of God.
Amen.
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 A sponge with sour wine. Put it on. It's a said is finished. Thank you, God. He finished it.
Oh, yeah.
Now it's up to us to start it.
Amen.
Keep it going.
Yeah.
Amen.
Right.
He finished it.
Yeah.
Where me and you can save somebody else.
Amen.
We can encourage somebody.
Amen.
Baptism will tell you what kind of friends you need to have.
Amen.
Don't you think around somebody that soon as things start flowing in your back, they can disappear. That's not a friend. That's someone just want to stay around because you had some money.
Yeah.
Things are going well for you.
Right.
But I'm here to tell you, say to God, it was finished.
Right.
Now, I'm with Jesus. Laid his head down and died. He knew it was coming. He knew it was coming when he had the last supper with his disciples. He told him, someone here is going to betray me.
Yeah.
He told him. And then what's so good about it? I love how Jesus, before he went to courtroom and courtroom, when he was a young man, he was reading the scriptures in the synagogues. Then when he got a little older, when he reached the age of 30, he got baptized. Then for about 3 more years, he started preaching the gospel. He started healing the sick. Started raising the dead. Opening blind eyes. Jesus had fun. Tell you and I that he's a man of God. And I'm here to tell you, thank you, God, in closing this out, that it is finished. Somebody say it's finished. But it starts again. Soon as you are converted. Soon as you become a disciple of Jesus Christ, it's your turn. The Bible said to go. Go. And preach the word. Watch other parts of the world. So it's up to us to preach, teach, encourage. The word is good news. The word is good news. So if you're right there bringing bad news, I don't know where that word came from, but if you are a true disciple of God, you know how to love somebody.
Amen.
God said, you don't know who my disciples are by the way they love one another. You don't know when you get a good man or woman of God by the way they conduct themselves, by the fruit that they bring. I mean to say, when Jesus said he was finished, surely he was expressing the form of relief that he was suffering was over.
Yeah.
It was over. He said it is finished. Meaning that it was meant, it was put apart. It is over with. It's finally done. And I'm telling you, I love how Jesus said it was finished. Means more than just this. It means that because of he finished it, you got to stop again and tell people about the word of God. If you want to have peace in your life, if you want to have love in your life, you got to have Jesus. And what Jesus is calling for now, he's calling for men and women that will spread the good news. It ain't all the preachers that spread the good news. It's for each and every one of us. Somebody, what Jesus has done for me, and how he can help you. But all you got to do is repent.
Yes, sir.
I love how Jesus, when he said it was finished, he realized that every human being, not just the Jews, the Gentiles, all of us said, no, that Jesus died for us. We have salvation.
Praise the Lord.
And that's what it's all about.
Amen.
spirit.
Yes, not only trust. Brought you my way.
Yeah.
Good.
So glad she took Donnie. God bless you, Lord God. Amen. Keep it with you. First lady. All right. Amen. I want to say this. Come on up, dude.
Praise the Lord.
Bless you.
Continue to pray for us, and we'll do it.
Baptist. Come on. Jesus, darling. Judas, you got something to say to him? Come on, we're mine. Let me tell you.
It's finished.
It's finished. He said it's finished. Let's go on. That's what we're going to do today. Come on. No? Okay, they finished. All right, now, I will say this one verse in this song, then we'll have cast remarks and benediction.
Jesus, be the fence all around me every day. Amen.